All right, okay, we're back. Part two of the packing system. And this is basically all about sort of the gear that's on our back going through the airport, not the bags we're checking, not our clothes, anything like that. I'm really just gonna go over the camera systems that I'm bringing from these next 20 days of assignment work. It's taking me to Greenland as well as to India. Now, something I said in the first video, if you didn't watch it, basically keep in mind, if I was traveling ultralight or backpacking through Europe or doing a personal trip, this would be a lot different, but I'm not. I'm here on assignment for a client. I have assistants working with me and a team that's here to create something. So I have to bring a lot more gear than I need. We're going to Greenland for about 10 days and then 2 days in Iceland, and then we're gonna be in India for like 13 days. So literally this is kind of one of those trips where I have to pack it all and I have to try to figure out how to do it as lightweight and streamlined as possible. So this gear is for multiple people, but I'm gonna explain why I'm bringing it all. So first things first, Pelican case. This is a laptop. We call this our Digi Kit, which means Digital Technician Kit, and essentially it's backup systems for our camera. In here is a laptop and an Apple laptop and two hard drives. Why? Because we want to be able to lock this unit to something. It's also waterproof. It's something that is safe in case we need to, gets dropped, right? It's something that's meant to protect our hard drives and all of our photos. So when we're on assignment, this is what we always bring. Anybody who's worked on commercial jobs usually understands that this is a critical thing you never want to lose, never want to damage. So we always pack our laptop and our hard drives into one of these. To get further information on what we use, why, and how we back up our cameras, I'd join a workshop or simply reach out to us. It's kind of more of an in-depth process. It's hard to explain on a video. So I'm gonna put this right here. Okay, what bag is going on our back? So we have two bags, my bag and my assistant's bag. And basically on this trip, he is bringing the Mountain Smith Tanuk 40. It's a 40 liter backpack that I designed with Mountain Smith. Why? Because I wasn't happy with what I saw out in the world and I wanted to make something rad. And so I did. We made a backpack that stands up on its own. It's got a waterproof bottom, so when you're at a wet beach, stands up. It basically is like a big kind of haul bag, like climbing style. So you can reach in, grab stuff out, right? It's also got a big sleeve, waterproof for wet board shorts, fins, crap that you might need to travel with that you don't want to have touch your main compartment. If you need to get into the main compartment, you can through the top or through the front, like this. Reach in, grab your camera gear out, whatever. Has some sleeves here, waterproof sleeves. Big side pockets for tripods. It's really simple. It's just a rucksack that's basically built burly. You could haul this thing up the side of a wall if you needed to. The Cordura is kind of made to endure. It's a little on the heavy side, but in terms of function, it's one of the best functioning bags I've ever found. And it's unpadded. So just keep in mind, this backpack is not meant to pad your cameras. That's what these are for. So this is the Tanuk 40. We sold out of all of our first editions. It actually won an award for design. We have some new ones coming in, I think, a month or so. Perfect. So my carry-on. I have a backpack too. I'll show you in a second. Plus this Eagle Creek roller. Okay? Rad. Why? Because it's literally exactly what fits overhead in a plane. What do I have in here? Let's go through it. I'm bringing two things. I have a water housing in here from, I'll pull that out, and then I'll pull this out. This is essentially all that's in here besides a pair of glasses, right? It's just a rad empty shell. You can cinch it down. It's burly. It will hold both sides, so it works really well. Cool. What's in here? This is a little Kinesis pack. In here is a Mavic drone, right? If you want to know what those look like, look it up. Really simple. Extra blades, extra batteries, charging kit. Everything fits in here really snug. It's like the perfect size for one of these. And this is made by K Gear. I bought it maybe like 8 years ago. Really effective little bag for something like this. Okay. Boom. Right. This is a water housing. Okay. I'm bringing a Sony A6500 water housing from Salty Housings. Why the Sony? Because it's super small and super light, and I know that I'm gonna be in Greenland shooting potentially icebergs, kayaking, whatever. I'm gonna bring a large dome so I can shoot over and under, right? Over under shots, right? One of my favorite things to shoot. I've also got in here, in addition to the Salty housing, I have a bag housing, which is kind of looks like a joke, but it actually works really well. This is basically a EWA Marine plastic bag housing. I've used this a lot over the years. It actually works extremely well. And both these are really meant to work with the A6500, and they're super effective for what they do. This is a fisheye for the A6500. So this whole thing fits in here pretty well. It's kind of a dialed little tight kit, and also have like a little thing to kind of dry everything off with as well. So boom. This is an old Mountain Smith basically bag, and it fits literally just right in there. If for some reason I get hassled, my carry-on's too big, I can just pull this out, shove it overhead. Why do I carry on a water housing? Because I've had a lot of instances where they have gotten broken in the check-in process. So I really try to make sure that I'm on it with that. So two other things. Actually, one last thing. So that was my carry-on. What is Ryan carrying on? What is his sort of handheld carry-on? He's bringing this drone, Phantom 4 drone, DJI. If you need to know what these look like, it's pretty simple. It all fits inside this. Right, and we're bringing that as a backup. We really want to shoot this place from an aerial perspective because we know we'll be limited to a boat. So being in Greenland, we want to keep in mind that we can bring any perspective we can to it. So this is why we're bringing two drones. One is just a backup. So we have these little, I don't even know who makes these, but they're these kind of perfect little kits, right, that hold all of our sort of charging and cleaning gear. And if I open this up right here, you'll see a variety of wires, cables. This is chargers. I've got Sony battery chargers here. I've got a big fast charging thing here. I hook this up to this cable, and I have four USB ports. Why? Because these cameras charge via USB, and I can charge my phone and everything else pretty much besides my laptop. This is like, that's the only thing I think I have that doesn't have USB. I also have a Goal Zero charging unit right in the bottom here as well for backup. So there is that. I also bring this small cleaning kit, okay? The best cleaning unit I've ever found is made by Visible Dust. It's called an Arctic Butterfly. It is a magnetized brush that basically cleans your sensor. Also, a manual blower unit. I've got some other tiny little like brushes and lens cleaners. A little sprayer for like lenses and stuff like that. And this is like a kind of a little miscellaneous kit that has a cable release for night exposures. It's got an extra tripod mount. It's got some an extra memory card, just kind of like an emergency kit for the camera in case I need to, you know, do surgery on something or have an extra piece here or there. So that's kind of what's in here. Extra cleansing cloth as well for the camera. So let's go over the gear. I have a lot of stuff here. And one thing you'll realize is that we use these kit cubes, we call them. They're actually made by Mountain Smith. And we designed these bags specifically to fit the cameras and the size of lenses we use, mainly because we're using smaller mirrorless cameras, mostly the Sonys, okay? So in here, I built these things so that you could basically take them out of your bag and just work directly out of them, right? Put it over your shoulder, have it really minimal. When I go backpacking, I take this out, put it in a different bag. Doesn't matter what I'm using or where I'm going, this is the bag that I take. And it holds one camera, 2 to 3 lenses in it. So what am I bringing? These are also available through Mountain Smith or on our website. What am I bringing? I'm bringing two ND filters, a 9-stop and a 6-stop or something like that, right? These are both Haida ND filters, okay? They work really well, and if you wanna check them out, they look like this, okay? Got those there. In this kit, I have this setup, right? This is a A7R2 with a fisheye on it. This is a third-party lens, meaning it's not made by Sony. It's actually a LOA, right? F2.8, aspherically corrected sort of fisheye. That means that the corners aren't as, you know, are bowed as normal fisheyes. It's a manual focus lens. I really like to shoot wide angle, so I brought this with me. That's this. Over here we have the 16-35 f2.8 lens, and this is a Sony lens, one of my favorites. On every single one of our lenses, we have a Hoya HD3 polarizer filter. I'm a big fan of polarizers. It's a filter that spins on the front. It cuts reflection from your image, and when you're shooting, say, icebergs or the glary surface of the ocean, that's usually what I like to use. In each of these, I have a camera cloth, always. On the front of these bags, I always keep batteries and one extra little camera cloth, right? That's pretty much what goes into both of these. Not all the bags have extra memory cards. Usually we keep the memory cards for one or two of the bags specifically. So I'm gonna try and go through the rest of these fairly quickly. Keep in mind, this is gear for a multitude of people, not just myself. If I was just going solo, I might bring just these or just this, but this is for me and somebody else, right? So you'll notice some duplicates in here. Here is a Sony A7 R2. By the way, these straps I'm using, these are made by Peak Design. They're really lightweight. They also pop on and pop off really quickly. And this is a 24-70 2.8 Hoya HD3. This is the 70-200 f/2.8 Sony lens. We just got it. We've been just starting to use it. Why would we bring this? We normally wouldn't, but if we see a polar bear, we'll need it. If we need to shoot surfing from kind of farther away, we'll also need it. So a lot of times it depends on what you're shooting. This is one of those situations where you're going to be getting into a really huge variety of shooting scenarios. So we want to be prepared for everything. So that's that. And then in this bag, one more of those graduated neutral density filters. The point of this filter is it darkens the sky and doesn't darken the ground, right? So you can shoot a sunset. In here, what do we have? We have the Sony A7S. Why the A7S? S stands for sensitivity. It's a camera that's optimized for shooting under low light conditions, northern lights, whatever. This is a 12-24, meaning that it is a super wide angle lens that if you're on the very top of a boat, you can shoot down. If you want to get really close to something, you can. This lens doesn't really have a mount for a filter on the front, so we would just run it without. The other lens that I always bring, and this is specifically something I only shoot for low light, is this 20mm f1.4. Why? Because it's optimized for shooting night sky or whatever. It's a great northern lights lens. I really like to shoot wide, and it's so you can get really the vastness of the night sky. So this is a lens we always bring. Last thing is this little smaller kit cube. These kit cubes come in three different sizes: small, medium, large. We aren't bringing any larges. This is an A6500 kit. Why are we bringing this? Well, we're bringing it for the water housing specifically. That's really the only purpose. And also just a backup camera because it shoots 10 frames a second or 11. So if I need to shoot something really fast and quick, polar bear running across, fish, animals, this is great. I have a 16-70 Zeiss lens in here and a 10-18 Zeiss lens in here. This, both these have HD3 Hoya polarizers on front of them. Now this kit is awesome, super small, super light, all packs down into this, and basically it's a wide angle and a zoom lens, right? Like I said, my water housing is really optimized for this camera because it's small and tiny and kind of fits really well in that lightweight setup. So this whole thing is packed with batteries and everything, everything I need. So that is the camera gear that I'm taking on this trip. I'm just gonna go over one sort of last thing, which is my personal bag I'm bringing on the trip that I would be carrying some of this camera gear in as well. So for this trip, this is a bag that I'm just using right now. I like to test out new products when I go on the road, so this is something I'm using. I've never used it before. It's a Kifuru backpack that has a big vertical zip down the front, really easy to access, plus a couple of variety of side pockets and whatnot. So what do I pack in this? It's pretty simple. I got this because I can basically throw a tripod or whatever I need to in here. Let me just pull out the remnants of this here so you can see it all, okay? That's empty. Boom. And the center. Now this bag is empty, right? packs down to kind of nothing, super lightweight, weighs like 3 pounds. It has an optional waist belt that I'll bring as well. But for the time being, this is kind of everything I have in here and everything I'm going to need. Cool. So that's that. Let me go through what I have in my bag. Hey, Ryan, can you check this battery on this camera? Thanks, Snacks. Cool. So I'm just going to go over quickly what I have in my personal pack. So I have another laptop, right? My personal MacBook Air that I travel with. In case I need to work, do emails, whatever. This is also something that works really well in case our other computer kind of fails or something like that. That's there. Tripod. My other Gitzo tripod. We're only bringing two. There's two of us shooting. This is just a super lightweight. This is the Traveler G-Lock. 3 foot extensions right here. Just one of my favorite lightweight. Weighs like 2 pounds or maybe 2.5 pounds. Packs down really small. So, and I always use these tripod kind of covers because I don't like them like scratching other gear here. Neck pillow thing. This is a really weird one, but I don't really mind being that weird person that's comfortable on the plane. So basically this thing just goes around and attaches here and you can kind of sleep like this. So you spend enough time on planes, you realize that that's critical. I also bring a little Eagle Creek inflatable neck pillow. Oftentimes on the boat or whatever, these are just awesome to have. So I've got two of these things. I always bring an extra little lightweight cloth, right? This is a camera cloth that essentially is basically a small kind of, I don't know, lightweight camping one. And it has a little buckle on here. I like to attach these to certain parts of my bag so that I don't lose them, right? So this is really good for cleaning cameras, wiping off whatever, drying stuff. Keep these in there. What else have I got? Rad rollers. These do kind of look like balls, but they essentially are. They basically go on your spine and under your legs and keep you from getting kind of like, you know, bound up while you're flying. I bring these all the time. This is like a super lightweight dop kit, like basically toothbrush, floss, all the stuff you need on the plane, right? Because oftentimes, say if nothing you pack or check arrives, you wanna have just the necessities. So I always try to pack with me the necessities to get to where I need to go, meaning camera gear and other stuff. So this always comes. A water bottle, just a tiny little plastic water bottle because I'm trying to use less plastic, so a reusable plastic one is a really helpful way to do that. This thing has a carabiner clip, so I can attach it somewhere. A tiny iPhone lens. I just bought this off Amazon, just something to shoot wide-angle iPhone videos in case I really want to. This just kind of goes in the side pouch of my pack as well. I think the brand is Amir, A-M-I-R. This is basically a kind of one thing does it all, USB to USB-C iPhone and micro USB cable. So this is awesome. I have more of these, but this is kind of one that I always keep handy next to me. This thing, simple, carries a wallet, headphones, and passport, right? And I'm the full-on nerd that will wear this around my waist. Fanny pack, I love it. It packs away, I always know where it is. I keep a tile in here to kind of keep my stuff organized and knowing where it is so I can find it in case something happens. And then a pair of sunglasses. I bring two always. And then the last thing is this little black case. And this is kind of my sort of do-it-all electronics case. I've got another sort of big multi-port country charger, my iPhone or my laptop charger, a wall charger, a car charger, a headlamp, a Haribo gummy freaking little camera cloth. I don't know why that's even in there. Headlamp that's USB rechargeable as well. In here I've got a Goal Zero charger unit as well for everything, and I always keep an extra iPhone because I'm on business and I need basically to be able to get a hold of people if one gets lost or breaks, right? So an extra iPhone, extra SIM card as well in this case that actually is meant to kind of keep it cool and not get too hot and not get too cold. Exactly. So next thing in here is just a little tiny pack of wires, right? iPhone cable, cable for audio in a car, whatever, micro USB, and then my coveted kind of Bose headphones. These are basically noise canceling. I just use them for the plane. I have a hard time sleeping, so these kind of cut the sound. Say if you're in a boat and it's loud, worst thing you could do is not get any sleep. So these things are crucial for that, and they aren't cheap, but they're worth it. In here, just a kind of a camera safe tool to open up your camera, tripod plate, a little flashlight as well. And that's really it in here. I don't think that there's anything else. Let me grab one more thing. So the last thing, and maybe one of the most important, is I bring these spot locators. We have four of them. 1, 2, 3, 4 units and a sat phone. So when I'm traveling to places where I know I'm gonna be off the grid, I wanna have a sat phone with me, get a hold of people, something's going on, need to get back, sat phone's critical. If I'm checking bags and I have expensive gear in them, I will put one of these in the bag so that I know where my bag is at all times. I've had stuff ripped off, I've had stuff stolen in airports. We make sure that security is really important to us, so we always track all of our, anything that is flown or checked or anything. This one is nice, it's also an SOS thing, so if I'm with a group somewhere and we're in a remote part of the world, we're going to some crazy islands off the Indian coast, we're gonna be in Greenland places, if something happens, this will issue a rescue signal anywhere in the world whenever we need. So that's crucial as well. So this is our little spot locator kit. So it's a lot of gear. I'm sure there's gonna be a lot of questions in the comments. We're gonna do our best to get to them. Once again, just to keep in mind, this is gear for a multitude of people traveling on assignment commercially. If I was gonna go solo or try to go lightweight, I'd be packing a lot less, but this is kind of the setup that I found to be the most simplified, and really it's just two duffel bags checked, two backpacks, and two kind of small carry-ons that we have with us, a drone and a water housing. So thank you guys so much for watching, and talk to you soon.